Hello everyone, welcome to our channel Political Science Tutorials. This is our 7th episode of MCQs on Indian Constitution and Administration. Please subscribe the channel for similar videos. Let us start with question number 1. Provisions related to the emergency added to the Indian Constitution in the light of the Constitution of Germany, UK, USA, Japan. Right answer is A, Germany. We know that in Indian Constitution there are so many provisions which are added following the constitution of other countries. The emergency provision is one of them which added in the light of Germany. Emergency provision, which is mentioned in part 18, is a unique feature of Indian Constitution that allows the center to assume wide powers so as to handle special situations. In this situation, the President of India has the power to impose emergency rule in any or all the Indian states if the security of part or all of India is threatened by war or external aggression or armed rebellion. In this situation, the center can take full legislative and executive and even financial control of any state. And in this period, freedom of citizens also suspended. In this slide, the mention of 3 articles on emergency has been done. Article 352, Article 356 and Article 360. Article 352, an emergency due to war and external aggression or armed rebellion, it is also known as national emergency. There is a brief discussion on national emergency or Article 352 in question number 3. Now Article 356, failure of constitutional machinery in states, also known as presidential rule. When it is imposed, if the governor of any state report to president that the constitutional machinery has been failed in that particular state and president is satisfied, then he or she can impose president's rule in that particular state. During state emergency, the union government has absolute control over the state except the judiciary. Many times this article has been applied to many states in India. Article 360. In this article there is a provision of financial emergency. So far in India, financial emergency never declared. From this discussion we came to know that 3 articles of emergency, those are 352, 356 and 360. 352 applied 3 times, we will discuss it later. 356 applied many times in many states. 360 never applied. And we came to know what happened when national emergency is declared. Now question number 2, who is the first Attorney General of India? Soli Sorabji, M.C. Setalwar, C.K. Daftari Niren De. Right answer is M.C. Setalwar. His tenure was from 1950 to 1963. In Indian Constitution, there is a mention of post of Attorney General in Article 76. Like any other organization, Indian government also need a chief legal advisor, and Attorney General is the Indian government's chief legal advisor. He or she is also the first law officer of India. Now the question is, by whom Attorney General is appointed? Attorney General is appointed by the President of India on advice of Union Cabinet under Article 76(1). what criteria a person must fulfill for becoming an attorney general. The person who is going to become an attorney general should qualify his eligibility of being appointed as a judge of the Supreme Court. Article 143 states that Attorney General also represent the government of India in any reference by the President to the Supreme Court. Attorney General is assisted by 5 officers, a Solicitor General and 4 additional Solicitor General of India. All references to the Attorney General are made by the Law Ministry. Now, present Attorney General is K.K. Venugopal from July 2017. From this discussion, we came to know the name of first Attorney General of India, name of present Attorney General of India, the Articles of Indian Constitution were mentioned about role of Attorney General, who appoints Attorney General, what criteria need to be fulfilled to become an Attorney General, who assists Attorney General, with whose reference Attorney General perform his or her role, etc. Hope these points are clear to you. Now question number 3. After independence, how many times national emergency has been declared in India? 2 times, 3 times, 4 times, never. Answer B, 3 times. Provisions of national emergency is in Article 52. It has been declared in India for 3 times. First, during the Indo-China War 1962 to 1968, when the security of India was declared as being threatened by external aggression. Second, during the Indo-Pakistan War for 3 months, December 1971 to March 1972. Third, on the basis of internal disturbance under controversial circumstances of political instability from June 1975 to March 1977. What happened when emergency declared? A national emergency modifies the federal system of government to a unitary one by granting parliament or central government the power to make laws on the 66 subjects of the state list. Also, all state money bills are referred to the parliament for its approval. Now, question number 4. Which statement is not true about All India Trade Union Congress? It was formed in 1920. It is true. Tilak played an important role. It is also true. Lala Lajpat Rai was its first president. It is also true. It was associated with Independent Labour Party. This is not true. So the answer is D. All India Trade Union Congress was not associated with Independent Labour Party. Now the question is, who formed Independent Labour Party? The Independent Labour Party, or ILP, was a political organization formed under the leadership of Dr. B.R. Ambedkar on 15th August 1936. Dr. Ambedkar was Independent India's first Minister of Law and Justice and also the chief architect of the Constitution of India. From this discussion, we came to know who formed Independent Labour Party and who was first Law Minister of India. Now, question number 5. Which is a writ issued by the court to bring before the court a person from illegal custody? Habeas corpus, mandamus, prohibition, certiorari. Answer is habeas corpus. Now we will discuss about five writs of Indian Constitution. There are five writs mentioned in Indian Constitution in Part 3, Article 32, known right to constitutional remedies. It is known as a guarantor of all other fundamental rights available to the people of India. And for this reason, this article is also called the heart and soul of the Constitution. Like Article 32, in Article 226, the Constitution empowers high courts to issue writs for the enforcement of any of the rights conferred by Part 3 and for any other purpose. So, Article 32 is for Supreme Court and Article 226 for High Court. In this matter, High Court's jurisdiction is broader as it is used for any other purpose including fundamental rights. But Supreme Court has only jurisdiction of fundamental rights, and in this sense, High Court's jurisdiction is broader. First, we will see the literal meaning of these five writs. Habeas corpus, meaning you may have the body. Mandamus means we command. Prohibition means to stop or forbid. Quo warranto means by what authority. Certiorari means to be certified. Now a brief discussion about these five writs. First, habeas corpus. This writ is issued to produce a person who has been detained, whether in prison or in private custody, before a court and to release him if such detention is found illegal, or if this detention is found illegal, then he or she will be released. Any relative or any person can petition a file on behalf of the detained person. Second, mandamus. Mandamus is an order from Supreme Court or High Court to a lower court or tribunal or public authority to perform a public or statutory duty. This writ of command is issued when any government, court, corporation or any public authority has to do a public duty but fails to do so. So this writ is to protect public interest. Next is prohibition. Prohibitions mean to forbid and popularly known as stay order. This writ is also issued when a lower court or a quasi-judicial body tries to transgress the limits of powers vested in it. The Supreme Court or High Court prohibits them to continue the proceedings in a particular case where it has no jurisdiction to try. So, it is a writ against a lower court or a quasi-judicial body. Next, certiorari. The writ of certiorari can be issued by the SC or HC for quashing the order already passed by an inferior court, tribunal or quasi-judicial authority. Certiorari is also against inferior court, tribunal or quasi-judicial authority. But when it is passed to quash or to invalidate the order which has been already passed. But prohibition is the writ which stop any inferior court or tribunal or quasi-judicial authority before the proceedings of decision making. So, difference of this writ with prohibition and certiorari is that prohibition is the writ which is issued before the proceedings of decision making, but certiorari is applied when a decision already has been taken. Quo warranto is a writ issued with the view to restrain a person from holding a public office to which he or she is not entitled. In simple words, when a person who is not eligible for any public office but holds the post is vulnerable to face this writ. From this discussion, we came to know the name of five writs. Which article is called the heart and soul of the Constitution? Which article is related with Supreme Court and which is related with High Court? Meaning of five writs. Again, I am briefing. Habeas corpus is to protect us from illegal detention. Mandamus, if any lower court or tribunal or public authority fails to protect public interest. Prohibition against any lower court, quasi-judicial or tribunal to stop any decision before it has been proceeding. Certiorari, it is also against lower court, tribunal or judicial body to invalidate the decision which already has been taken. Quo warranto is to restrain any person from holding a post illegally. Now, question number 6. Which articles of Indian Constitution ensured cultural and educational rights? Answer is Article 29 and 30. Part 3 of Indian Constitution from Article 12 to 35 deals with fundamental rights. Article 29 and 30 is about cultural and educational rights. This fundamental right preserves the right of any section of citizens to conserve their culture, language or script, and right of minorities to establish and administer educational institutions of their choice. Question number 7. Which article of Indian Constitution prohibits child labor? Article 22, 24, 30, 33. And right answer is B, Article 24. Child Labor Act. When first Child Labor Act was implemented in India in the year 1938 or in British India. Children Act of 1938 was the first act to prevent child labor. But in practice, there was no prevention of child labor in India. After independence of India also, there it was continuing. Indian Parliament enacted the Child Labor Act of 1986. This law identified 83 occupations as hazardous and made a list of these 83 occupations. Then the National Policy of Child Labor of 1987, implemented in 1988, focused on the rehabilitation of children working in hazardous occupations. In Indian Constitution, rights against exploitation is stated in Article 23 and Article 24. Article 23, prohibition of human trafficking and forced labor, and Article 24 is about prohibition of employment of children in factories, etc. So, rights against exploitation is in Article 23 and Article 24. Question number 8. Which following pair not correctly matched? Ruling plan, National Front Government, 20-point program, Congress government, review of the working of the Constitution, NDA 1 government, National Rural Employment Guarantee Act, UPA 1 government. Answer is A. Ruling plan is not matching with National Front Government. First, let us discuss about the meaning of ruling plan. The meaning of the ruling plan was that now every year the performance of the plan will be assessed and a new plan will be made next year based upon this assessment. Now, Which government is related to ruling plan? The Janata government is related to ruling plan. The Janata government came into power in 1977 and it terminated the fifth five-year plan and launched its own sixth five-year plan for period of 1978 to 83 and called it a ruling plan. But due to dismissal of Janata government in 1980, a fresh election was held and National Congress government formed. And after that, a new sixth plan was made. In this brief video, we have discussed about some important topics which are helpful for any competitive exam. Hope all these points are clear to you. Please subscribe the channel and share it with your friends. Share your view in comment box. Thank you for watching.